Hello everyone, I am Professor P.S. Baravkar. Today we see experiment number 3, analysis of the pneumatic circuits on pneumatic trainer kit. So first of all we see introduction, analysis of the following pneumatic circuit on the pneumatic trainer. In that experiment we can analyze different types of pneumatic circuits on a pneumatic trainer. Okay, so first circuit is a automatic reciprocating circuit, speed control circuit, pneumatic circuit involving shuttle valve and quick exhaust valve. Okay, so first of all we see automatic reciprocating circuit, after that speed control, and after that pneumatic circuit involving shuttle valve or quick exhaust valve. So first one is a automatic reciprocating circuit. So in that construction and working, firstly we discuss construction of automatic reciprocating circuit. Constructing the automatic reciprocating circuit consists of FRL unit, 4x2 double solenoid operated double acting cylinder. Okay, those component we can use. FRL means filter regulator lubricator. Okay, so next point is the working of automatic reciprocating circuit. So in that first one is a position of a 4x2 directional control valve. Okay, is used, air is flow from P point to A and B to T. Hence the cylinder is a flow from entered by the end of extension, the cam filtered to the position red rod face, a limit switch LS2. Hence the electric current flow through the solenoid S2 due to this shift to second position. The second position retraction, the cam presses the limit switch LS. Hence S1 due to the speed of 4x2 directional control valve shifted to first position, and the cylinder is continuing. So this is a circuit diagram of a automatic reciprocating circuit. So we discuss a component. So basic component, this is a FRL unit, fluid regulator lubricator. After that next connection is a directional control valve, 4x2 directional control valve we can use here. So in directional control valve we use control mechanism is solenoid coil. So that type of valve is known as solenoid operated directional control valve. So this is a suction lines. After that this is actuator. Okay, so whole circuit is this circuit is a automatic reciprocating circuit. Next one is a speed control circuit. So what is speed control? We can controlling a speed of actuator, okay, by using a flow control valves. So speed control circuit has three types. First one is a meter in circuit, meter out circuit, and bleed off circuit. So in a speed control circuit, so construction throttle in a circuit for extension consist of FRL unit, 4x2 DCB double acting cylinder we can use. Okay, so working is in a first position of 4x2 directional control valve. 4x2 directional control valve, the compressed air is flow from P to A and B to T. This flow is through a few, the flow is controlled and hence position extend slowly. In a second position of a DCV, the flow controlled and hence compressed air flow from P to A and A to T. This flow is through check the valve. This is a free flow. Hence, the piston rod at higher speed, which is not controlled. So this is working of a speed control circuit. All of you see, if this is a diagram, circuit diagram of speed control circuit. So we discuss basic component of speed control circuit. So this is the FRL unit, fluid regulator, lubricator, 4x2 directional control valve we can use here. So in a speed control circuit, we can use flow control valve in between DCB and inlet of actuator. We can attach or we can mount flow control valve on suction line. Okay, so that type of circuit is known as mid-range circuit or speed control circuit. So next is a pneumatic circuit involving shuttle valve or quick exhaust valve. So in that pneumatic circuit involving quick exhaust valve construction and working, firstly we discuss construction. The pneumatic circuit using a quick exhaust valve consists of FRL unit, directional control valve, quick exhaust valve, double acting cylinder. Okay, so those are the basic component of pneumatic circuit. Next point is the working of a circuit involving shuttle valve. So working is, in first position of DCV, compressed air is flows from P to A and B to T. Air present in the rod end side of the cylinder is exhaust to the sphere of the quick exhaust valve. The second position of DCV, compressed air in a head inside of cylinder is exhausted to atmosphere through a quick valve in a second position, and L/2 DCV, compressed air flow from P to B and A to T. Okay, in the head and side of cylinder, exhaust to atmosphere through quick exhaust valve. So next circuit is a electro-pneumatic valve, by using electro-pneumatic valve. Okay, so this is a circuit diagram of electro-pneumatic valve. Same, this is a electro-pneumatic electro-pneumatic valve circuit diagram. It consists of FRL unit, directional control valves, okay, actuators. So this is a position, first position, this is second position, this is first position, this is second position. So this is a schematic diagrammatic circuit diagram of electro-pneumatic valve. Okay, next one is a next point is we discuss here conclusion. What is the conclusion of this experiment? So in this experiment, we studied the various pneumatic circuits act like automatic reciprocating circuit, speed control circuit, circuit using a quick exhaust valve, and electro-pneumatic circuit by using a pneumatic trainer kit. Okay, so this is the main conclusion. In a pneumatic trainer kit, we analyze different types of pneumatic circuits like reciprocating circuit, speed control circuit. Speed control circuit has also three types: meter in circuit, meter out circuit. Okay, and after that, using quick exhaust valve and electro pneumatic circuit. So this is the main conclusion of that experiment. Okay, thank you.